My name is Chris McIntosh. I am the CEO of Turning Point Centers here in Sandy, Utah. And today I'm going to talk a little bit about addiction in the brain. We all have heard that addiction is a disease, but more specifically, addiction is a brain disorder. This part of the brain is the prefrontal cortex. It's the cognitive or conscious part of the brain. We use this part of the brain every day for higher functioning, language, mathematics. This is the logical, rational part of our brain. This part that's colored in is called the limbic system or the midbrain. Definitely not rational or logical part of the brain. This is the part of us that is hardwired to survive. It keeps us alive biologically speaking. So it regulates all of our survival instincts. It tells us we're hungry, we're thirsty, drives our desire for companionship, the instinct to protect and provide for our children. If you've ever been in any kind of a situation where you're in imminent danger and you sort of go on autopilot and then you look back and you think, wow, what just happened? That's a very good example of the way the brain is designed. The limbic system hijacks the prefrontal cortex to ensure our safety, and then once the environment or the threat is gone, the environment's returned to normal, perceived as normal, the limbic system takes a more passive role. Experts say that addiction is about 50% genetic in nature, and so for those people with the genetic predisposition towards substance abuse, what happens is they get exposed to drugs and alcohol. They find that it changes the way that they feel. They like that. They begin to seek it out. And over time, the midbrain or the limbic system gets very excited. Eventually, it becomes overstimulated, maybe confused, till it reaches a point where it flips the switch. And when it flips the switch is when addiction really takes root. The brain actually begins to perceive that the compulsion to use is a survival mechanism. It's almost as if the individual develops an instinct towards intoxication itself. Getting loaded means more than holding on to a job, paying your bills, taking care of your relationship with your loved ones, taking care of yourself. You know, you see people drink themselves to death and you wonder why. Well, from a biological standpoint, they truly believe that the need for alcohol is a priority over the need to care for their well-being. And so, it's very hard to just ask someone to stop. I mean, it's no different than if I ask you to hold your breath for 10 minutes. You can try. You might get 30 seconds, 60 seconds, 90 seconds if you're well conditioned, but eventually the limbic system is going to hijack the prefrontal cortex and you're going to gasp for air. We can't escape the fact that we're hardwired to survive, and addiction tricks us into believing that that compulsion to use is necessary for our survival.